That's my grandbaby's in there.
Anything you want to say on his behalf?
He's a fine man. And thank you, Mr. Trump, for inviting a ride at the White House.
And you're his grandmother?
I'm his grandmother.
This is West Virginia State Delegate Derek Evans being taken into federal custody after his involvement with a Trump-inspired insurrection at the Capitol. And he was charged with entering a restricted building, violent entry, and disorderly conduct. But probably the most striking part here is that his grandmother doesn't leave a shred of doubt as to who she blames for all of this, stating, quote, "Thank you, Mr. Trump, for inviting a riot at the White House." That is not what you say as your grandson is being arrested if you're especially pleased with the president. Now, the arrest wasn't necessarily surprising, as Evans live-streamed his participation in the riot, which he duly deleted once he realized that he only made it easier for federal agents to find him. But if we know one thing about the internet, it's that it happens to be forever.
I'm not going anywhere. This guy's got a police officer riot thing. I can't move either direction.
And by the way, Evans isn't close to being the only one arrested for his involvement in the insurrection. You've probably seen this viral photo of Richard Barnett from Arkansas with his feet up on Nancy Pelosi's desk. He doesn't seem quite as chipper in his new mugshot. Police also arrested a 70-year-old man for possessing 11 Molotov cocktails, and the arrest will continue as those who stormed the Capitol are held to account for their actions. And if you were wondering how deep the rot into the GOP goes, consider the fact that Evans was just sworn in West Virginia. This is the future of the Republican Party, and a number of freshman congresspeople and senators also went on to object to the certification of the election even after the violence occurred, meaning that they saw firsthand the mayhem that their whole charade caused, and yet still perpetuated it. Still, they continued to promote the exact same disinformation that only hours earlier left people dead and injured. That is how committed they are to the destruction of our system of government. Now, even though people like Derek Evans should know better and should undoubtedly be held accountable for what they've done to the fullest extent of the law, the principal fault here for inciting this riot in the first place lies with Donald Trump. And that's a sentiment shared across the aisle as calls for removal grow louder and louder. Senator Lisa Murkowski has outright called for his removal from office, saying, quote, "I want him to resign. I want him out. He has caused enough damage. I think he should leave. He said he's not going to show up. He's not going to appear at the inauguration. He hasn't been focused on what is going on with COVID. He's either been golfing or he's been inside the Oval Office fuming and throwing every single person who's been loyal and faithful to him under the bus, starting with the vice president. He doesn't want to stay there. He only wants to stay there for the title. He only wants to stay there for his ego. He needs to get out. He needs to do the good thing, but I don't think he's capable of doing a good thing." She even added, quote, "If the Republican Party has become nothing more than the party of Trump, I sincerely question whether this is the party for me." That followed this address by Republican lawmaker Adam Kinzinger, who called outright for the 25th Amendment to be invoked and for Trump to be removed from office.
"Yesterday was a sad day, as we all know. It was the day where fire stoked by the president and other leaders finally leapt out of the pit, and it lit the trees. Thankfully, the strength of our Constitution and democracy held, and we emerged today a little battered, but resolved. What happened yesterday is a wake-up call to many, but it's a call to accountability for others. In the past few presidencies, the administrations have been so concerned about even a moment of weakness that the 25th Amendment was invoked during minor surgeries, passing the duties to the vice president while the president was under anesthesia, because even for that moment to have the captain of the ship absent could cause a major catastrophe. Sadly, yesterday, it became evident that not only has the president abdicated his duty to protect the American people and the people's house, he invoked and inflamed passions that only gave fuel to the insurrection that we saw here. When pressed to move and denounce the violence, he barely did so, while of course victimizing himself and seeming to give a wink and a nod to those doing it. All indications are that the president has become unmoored, not just from his duty, nor even his oath, but from reality itself. It is for this reason that I call for the vice president and members of the cabinet to ensure the next few weeks are safe for the American people, and that we have a sane captain of the ship. Section 4 of the 25th Amendment allows a majority of the cabinet and the vice president to assume the duties of the office of presidency until the president is able to himself. It's time to invoke the 25th Amendment and to end this nightmare. We will arise from this, but we cannot forget what led us here. The liars and conspiracy authors are already at it again this morning with false narratives about yesterday's disaster. Here's the truth. The president caused this. The president is unfit, and the president is unwell. And the president must now relinquish control of the executive branch voluntarily or involuntarily.
Even Robert Ray, one of the lawyers who defended Trump from impeachment, says this time is different and that there could actually be a case against him. He explained, quote, "Unlike the last time where they didn't even charge a crime, I could imagine that you could draft an article of impeachment that would actually make a legal argument that the president aided or abetted or actually elicited a riot." Meaning that even the people who thought that a phone call where he made his intended extortion clear as day wasn't incriminating know that Trump really has no leg to stand on here. And it seems that impeachment is actually well on its way to becoming a reality. Nancy Pelosi released a statement saying, quote, "It is the hope of members that the president will immediately resign, but if he does not, I've instructed the Rules Committee to be prepared to move forward with Congressman Jamie Raskin's 25th Amendment legislation and a motion for impeachment." And given the fact that we'd more likely see the sun envelop the solar system today than for Trump to resign, it looks like Congress is going to be making good on its promise to seek Trump's removal from office immediately. The simple fact is this. Until and unless the people responsible for this violence are held to account, there's no way to ensure that it won't happen again in the future. So everyone from Derek Evans in West Virginia all the way to Donald Trump need to face consequences, because if they don't, all it'll say is that there are no lengths too far to go to if you want to throw a temper tantrum for losing an election. This isn't only about accountability now, it's about protecting our democracy from this point on. While you're here, please check out my podcast, No Lie with Brian Tyler Cohen. I take a deep dive into the top stories of the week, and I also interview major players in the world of politics, like Kamala Harris, Adam Schiff, Nancy Pelosi, Pete Buttigieg, Katie Porter, Al Franken, Cory Booker, Jamie Harrison, Mary Trump, and many more. Again, that's